So we are in the simulation center. We spend a lot of our time here for clerkships, learning the basic skills that we'll need to go over for each individual clerkship we have in our third and fourth years.
This is a 10,000 square foot facility where we have what we call high fidelity simulators that can go into cardiac arrest, can develop pulmonary edema, can develop an acute abdomen. We have outstanding pediatric simulators now. Our newest pediatric simulator is almost frighteningly realistic. We have Victoria. Victoria is a birthing simulator where they can learn not only the mechanics of delivering a baby under normal circumstances, but some of the complications that could occur. So we can put them in scenarios that are very realistic.
In a life and death situation, you don't want to be trying out new things or training new people on procedures they're only doing for the first time. And so here, we're able to go through the same sort of nuts and bolts of what needs to be done. And they do a really good job of creating a stressful environment to make it very lifelike so that when it comes time to actually perform, we're much more prepared to do so.
I find the CMU medical students just totally engaged with this platform, with their medical education. It's a pleasure to work with them. Just intense enthusiasm for learning medicine, being sponges for knowledge.
All the training that we received here has been, I believe, kind of world class. The leadership here has done a great job of growing the school. Every single year I can see the students getting better and better. I still do a lot of work and research down in the Detroit area. Every time I talk about CMU College of Medicine, everyone speaks very highly of all of our faculty, from our dean on down.
The only complaint I ever get about this level of simulation is they're not getting enough of this level of simulation.
Medical education is going through a transformative period right now, where it is more case-based learning and hands-on procedures such as the simulation lab.
I think in 10 years, there won't be a single procedure that anyone does on any patient that they haven't checked out first on a simulator.
To the donors, I just want to say a huge thank you. There's no way we'd be able to have the simulation center and the ability to train world-class physicians like we're hoping to train here at CMU without your donations.
Simulation medicine at this level is expensive. And the only way we can sustain this high level of education is with donations. Of course, if we make better medical students, if we make better residents, they stay in our community, we're going to give better medical care to the community. We're going to have better standard of care for our patients as a whole. So yes, I think simulation's the answer to eliminating many of the medical errors that we've seen in the past and increasing the level of competence before someone even sees a patient.
Fire up chips.